So the question is, since that happened last September 27th, why did I wait so long to make videos? Well, here's the reason I waited so long to make videos, and it's still in my face right now. This coming Tuesday, I have the pre-trial with my ex-girlfriend's lawyer, I guess. I don't even think she's going to be there, on custody of my children. And I've gone on about that around enough times to even have to say anything about it. Basically, my kids live with people, and they're surrounded by people who sit and watch TV, are obese and lazy. And if you saw that family, you'd see what I mean. I'm not making this up. And they really have no interest in the kids besides just keeping them, you know, out of their hair and, you know, keeping them occupied so that they don't have to deal with anything. And they're okay with do whatever you want as long as we don't hear about it. You know, you can be doing all kinds of crazy dumb stuff, but if you don't get in trouble for it, that's fine. No, that's not how it should be. But here's the reason I waited. Because not only was I worried about my family being made fun of or losing the love of my family, well, that's happening. And I don't know why. Like, to get it all, you have to lose it all. But I don't deserve to lose it all. I love my kids. And I mean, I was just talking to somebody at one of my stops, and she was like, I was saying, like, isn't that messed up that the lawyer agrees with me, but says that he can't have a personal preference or have a personal opinion because he's representing, you know, the other person. But to me, I'm thinking, if it's right, it's right. Take it. Why would you? And the girl says, well, she has her right to legal representation. But here's the problem. The law itself is fucked. If anyone doesn't believe that or think that, if they don't agree, then I'm sorry, but the law is fucked. We know that a murderer can get away with murder if, you know, the lawyer finds a stipulation that they missed or something wrong with the trial. You know, they look for, like, you know, someone didn't, one of the jurors didn't have their shoelace tied when they said guilty. Throw out the case, you know. I mean, that's, you know, exaggeration, but still, like, I'm a good dad. I have nothing but good intentions and nothing but good actions in store for anyone who involves themselves with me. I honestly know that I can help the world. I'm not one of those people who just says it with some, you know, whimsical thing. This is my life now. I understand the reality of being here. I really don't think, I mean, honestly, I know, but I don't want to insult anybody. People don't know what they're doing here. And they don't know why they're here. They just go about it blindly. And someone trying to help them gets overlooked or gets looked at like, what do you know? Who are you? You know? But that's the reason I waited so long, because I didn't want to lose my kids. I didn't want to be considered crazy. I didn't want, you know, there's some things that I'm able to do that if I showed people I could do them, I would get in lots of, like, people would be worried or scared of me. Like, superpowers. I know it sounds really weird, but I don't have to prove anything. And in fact, I've tried to not focus on those things because they scared me when they happen. And like, it blew my son's mind. And like, he thinks I'm God, you know? And honestly, I know I am, but I know everybody is. I just know that I'm realized and I understand where we're all going, what we're all doing. Space isn't even space. That's not even there. That's just a representation from our eyeballs. But anyway, that doesn't matter. Like, I don't want to go into some philosophy or psychology or science, anything like that, because none of that matters. What I'm saying right now is that's the reason I waited so long, is because I was afraid to lose the people that matter to me. And because I brought up my experience to my kids, my ex thinks I'm crazy and she's trying to take my kids from me. You know? Like, when I'm with my kids, I don't really mention that very often. You know, I may say some loving things or about nature and stuff like that, but I'm not like God, 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 God. I'm not. In fact, when I first started saying it, I told him, you know, like I've said this before, I don't want you guys to feel odd with me talking like this. So just let me know if, you know, if you don't want me to talk about this kind of stuff or whatever. You're like, I watch my language around my kids. I don't swear around, especially my younger two. My older ones, I sort of swear around when we joke around because they're older and they swear. And that's not that it's okay, but words are just words anywhere. You can say some of the nicest things with a swear word involved, and it's not a bad thing. Anyway, so that's why I waited so long, because I was afraid to lose the things that matter to me in this physical world. And now, this physical world doesn't accept me. I mean, I put these videos out. I know that the content in the videos that I have is just sort of minor. I'm trying to, like, hint towards it. At the same time, I've said some major things, but people aren't listening. People aren't paying attention because they're too sidetracked with other stuff. And I'm right about that. And I'm not making an opinion, or I don't think I know. I know. And I'm sorry that people are so stubborn and pig-headed that they won't listen to somebody who has the experience, who knows what they're talking about. But that's fine. I mean, I love them anyway. It's their right to do that. But it seems like the world itself is choosing to let people control them. I'm not. And like, I have to go to court Tuesday, and I have to play the game, and I have to do all this stuff, and I almost just don't want to go. I shouldn't go. I have nothing to defend. Like, my ex gets the bug up her ass and says she's going to take my kids away, and now she has a lawyer who's trying to take my kids away? For what reason? No harm has been done to my kids. In fact, all that I've done for my kids is good. I help them with their homework when I see them. You know, I let them pick some cartoon movies. We don't watch anything with vulgarity or violence or anything like that. Like, I try really hard to keep their childhood as an innocent childhood. But my ex, who they live with and who's trying to get sole custody of them, sort of ruins that when she plays Pop That Coochie and shit in her car. I mean, whoever's out there right now, if anyone even listens to this, because I don't expect people to take their time from, you know, their whatever they're doing, that's probably nonsense, to listen to somebody who means something, like me. But anyway, I don't even know what the hell I'm trying to say right here, and I'm not going to edit it, because it doesn't matter. But people that have little kids and they drive around with motherfucker, bitch, gang, nigga, what the fuck? Like, you think that's okay? Yeah, I said nigga. Who cares? I've been black before. And people won't understand that either, because some people don't believe in reincarnation. Well, if you don't believe in reincarnation, you'll be dirt when you die. You know, I'm sorry. Your belief systems are what take you where you go. Your belief and your knowledge. So go out there and find out. I can help anybody who wants to know. I can't sit around and be quiet about it anymore. I'm willing to just, I mean, I'm not crazy. In fact, I'm the only person that I know that isn't. The world itself is, if we keep going doing the same thing, that's the definition of insanity. We're doing the same things over and over. We're having a revolution, not an evolution. Let's do an evolution. Something better. Something better than this crap. Like, there's no reason for half the shit we do. I mean, if I'm wrong, somebody comment. Somebody say something. Somebody open their mouth, please. I don't understand why I can't get interaction from people. I love you guys. Every single one of you. Anybody out there. Anything out there. I love you. We're all one. Literally. So why are we trying to pull ourselves apart? Let's stop. Let's take a deep breath and think about it. Okay? I don't want to keep going on, but that's the reason I waited. Because people just don't care enough. Start caring, please.